Welcome to the Spy Collection. I'm Anastasios and for this episode we have a covert listening device from the United Kingdom. This one. An identical device was used in mid-June of 2013 inside the Embassy of Ecuador in London to spy on WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange, who seeked asylum there. According to Ricardo Patiño, Ecuador's foreign minister during that incident, the spy device was installed by the private British firm Surveillance Group Ltd on behalf of the British and US governments. But Surveillance Group Ltd quickly disputed those claims, denying any involvement in the espionage case. Here's a short video from that press conference of Ecuador's foreign minister Ricardo Patiño explaining what happened.
En el interior del micrófono espía viene incorporada una tarjeta SIM de teléfono móvil de una compañía de telecomunicaciones puntera en el país, la cual puede ser activada desde cualquier terminal telefónico, sea fijo o móvil. Con una simple llamada al número de la tarjeta SIM, se realiza la llamada, automáticamente se descuelga, pasando de esta forma al modo escucha y por consiguiente a la transmisión amplificada de toda la información captada hasta el dispositivo que realiza la llamada. Ahí adentro de esa caja, que aparecía como una caja de luz abierto. Tenemos fundadas sospechas de que las escuchas corrieron a cargo de la empresa de Surveillance Group Ltd. Esta compañía es una de las mayores empresas privadas en investigaciones y vigilancia encubierta en el Reino Unido. Y sus oficinas están localizadas en Hereford y en Worcester, en el Reino Unido. Después de esta determinación, después de esta información de la que disponemos, el gobierno del Ecuador va a pedir la colaboración del gobierno británico para apoyar una investigación sobre este asunto de nuestra parte, para conocer hasta el fondo quiénes son las instancias implicadas en la operación de espionaje en nuestra embajada.
And with all that context, let's have a look at the device itself. On the front it appears like a standard UK main socket, and it even works as such if you plug in a device. However, looking at its rear side, it's immediately clear that there is more to it. This is a real, normal main socket, but it has been modified to include this bug. Can you see those tiny cables here? Those are used to power the bug, which means that as long as you install it, it can work virtually forever. This is its microphone. And here is its GSM antenna. And here you can install the SIM card to connect to the cellular network. It has two modes of operation. On the first, you just call it and it will auto-respond, allowing you to hear anything each microphone can capture. And the second mode is voice activation. For this, you send an SMS message to the SIM card installed in the bug with either 1111 or 0000 to enable or disable this feature respectively. And once it detects any voice, it will call back the number that was used to activate it. Such badging devices aren't anything new. However, as it was clearly demonstrated by the Embassy of Ecuador in London in 2013, nation states could use them since they provide strong deniability and still allow intercepting communications from hard targets. Note, however, that for any nation state, detecting and eliminating such simple GSM-based bugs is a relatively easy task, but that's a topic for TSCM that we might cover in a future episode. In conclusion, in an era of technological advancement, where such spy gadgets are readily available, everyone's awareness should be equally sophisticated. The fact that a simple covert listening device like this was actually used against a nation-state actor underscores the importance of constant vigilance, because nothing is as it seems.